Hello viewers, welcome to the simplified concepts. Welcome to my new video on electrolytic conductivity and conductance. After a long time I make this video. I am absolutely sorry for this, but it is fact that I am also a student like you. Sometimes I involved in study. In the intermediate time I have faced some types of homeworks like you, so I cannot make this video. So forget about it. After completing kinetic theory of gas, I started chemical conductivity and conductance, electrolytic conductivity and conductance, sorry. I still remember in previous video lecture, I discussed about specific conductance. I think you have a clear concept on a specific conductance. So today we'll start the equivalent conductance. I say that what is equivalent conductance and what it is importance. Let's start. Before discussing it, I will say the definition of equivalent conductance. Okay, that equivalent conductance is a conductance of 1 gram equivalent electrolyte placed between two electrodes 1 centimeter apart. I repeat that equivalent conductance is a conductance of 1 gram equivalent electrolyte placed between two electrodes 1 centimeter apart. Let me derive it. Let me discuss here the equivalent conductance. The equivalent conductance is indicated by the capital letter lambda. Okay. Consider a C normal solution. So, here we discuss the C normal solution. Then, C gram equivalent of electrolyte in 1000 cc solution, then 1 gram equivalent of electrolyte in 1000 by cc solution. We get the volume of 1 gram equivalent electrolyte which discuss in definition. Okay. Here, small l, this stands for the length between two electrodes is 1 centimeter from definition. V, the volume we get, that 1000 by cc, 1000 by c, semi cube. So, from this, it is easy to get the value of A, that A equal to V by L equal to 1000 by c. Okay. That from the previous video I discussed that L stands for the conductance of electrolyte equal to kappa into A by L, where A is the area of the electrode and L is the length between two electrodes. That here we substitute that L by lambda, and lambda equal to kappa into A is 1000 by C by 1, L equal to 1. So we get that lambda equal to 1000 kappa by c. Okay. As equivalent conductance is one type of electrolytic conductance, so like electrolytic conductance, equivalent conductance depends on some factor. First, the length between two electrodes and the area of the electrodes. The length between two electrodes we fix in the definition 1 centimeter.
Second part is the number of the ions per unit volume. Keeping 1 gram of equivalent electrolyte, we also fix it. So we measure the conductance of 1 gram electrolyte. 1 gram equivalent electrolyte. Okay. The last part is that the mobility of the ions. The mobility of the ions is an important part in case of the equivalent conductance. Okay. Let's we discuss about the part.
In previous video lecture, we see that the chemical conductance or electrolytic conductance change with mobility of the ions. It is also a proportional relation that when the mobility of ions increase, the conductance also increase. As equivalent conductance is a one type of electrolytic conductance is also increased when mobility of the ions increase. Here, this is not important part. Here is important part how the mobility of the ions increase with concentration, or what is the relation between the concentration and the mobility of the ions. Here, I will show you an important equation which show that how the mobility of the ions change with the concentration. It will increase or it will decrease. So, you can see the equation.
The equation that I say that mobility change with concentration, this equation, that this is an important equation, this expressed by that mu. Mu stand for the mobility of the ions equal to mu naught minus B root C, where that mu stands for mobility of the ions. Mobility of ions. Okay. And C stands for concentration. Concentration. Okay. If you see this equation, then you can easily say that this is a straight line equation. That this Y, this is C, and this is minus of mx. Okay. This is a straight line equation. This is the straight line equation with a negative slope. Here I try to draw the graphical representation of the equation. This is that mu, and here is that root over C. The equation is that mu equal to mu naught minus P root of C, where C stand for the concentration and mu stand for the mobility of the ions. So the graphical representation is this. Okay, this. It easily implies that with increasing concentration, the mobility is going to decrease. With increasing concentration, the mobility is going to decrease. So the mobility is higher in the lower concentration zone. In the lower concentration zone, you can see the mobility is higher. Okay, and in the higher concentration zone, the mobility is lower. You can get the mobility is lower. Okay, you see the graphical representations. Here, this is an important point which I discussed in previous video, that the mobility is direct proportional relation with the conductance of the ions. Equivalent conductance is one type of conductance. So, equivalent conductance has a proportional relation with the mobility. So, we easily change the equation, we substitute mu by the lambda, and we get the equation by substituting mu by lambda, we can get the equation that lambda equal to lambda naught minus B root C. This equation implies how the equivalent conductance is changed with the concentration. Okay, this implies that how the equivalent conductance is changed with the concentration. This is an important equation. If I plot in graphical representation, that it will just like the straight line with negative slope. That here lambda and here is concentration. Okay, you can see the graphical representation, and this point is called that lambda naught. This point is called that lambda naught. So what is lambda naught? What the lambda naught actually implies? Here we start about the discussion on the lambda naught. You can see the graphical representation here. This point is called the lambda naught. Okay, this point is called lambda naught. This lambda naught implies lambda naught is the special value of lambda. Lambda naught is a special value of lambda in which concentration equal to zero. You can see lambda naught is a special value of lambda in which concentration, that C, equal to zero. So this is an important part which we will discuss. But you see, the lambda naught is a value of lambda in which concentration is zero. This implies that lambda naught is a characteristic of pure solvent, not solution. It is a characteristic of pure solvent, because as the concentration is zero, there is no solute, so that it is the characteristic of your solvent. If anyone asks you that you get a NaCl solution, a KCl solution, if the both solution have equal lambda naught or not, your answer is generally from this graphical representation, you will say yes, the both solution have the equal lambda naught. But actually, experimentally, this is not. This is wrong. Because the scientist, when they try to experiment this, they will get the different value of lambda naught for NaCl solution, for KCl solution, for others. Okay. So what is the funda here? Let's discuss. Let we discuss what the concentration implies. That concentration C concentration implies that number of ions by volume. The number of ions by volume. If you say that concentration that C equal to zero, then here will be the two cases. At first, that number of ions is equal to zero. If the number of ions equal to zero, then there is a no solute present in the solution. Then the lambda naught in the C equal to zero, you get the value of lambda is lambda naught. Then if number of ions equal to zero, then C equal to zero, it implies that the lambda naught is a characteristic of pure solvent. But experimentally, this is not. Experimentally, this is not. It implies that number of ions is not equal to zero. Then the other option is that volume is infinity. If volume is infinity, then C will be zero. Then you can say that lambda equal to lambda naught. So it implies that it is not a characteristic of a pure solvent, but it is characteristic of a solution in which the solution is dilute infinitesimally. Okay. It implies that it is not a characteristic of pure solvent. It implies that it is the characteristic of the solution in which the solution is dilute infinitesimally. So that's why the lambda naught is called that equivalent conductance at infinitesimal dilution. That lambda naught is called equivalent conductance at infinitesimal dilution. Okay.
I think you get a sufficient concept of lambda naught, what the lambda naught actually implies. Let us discuss that what is infinitesimal dilution. Okay. In case of concentration, I say that the concentration is number of ions by volume. I say in case of lambda naught that here the concentration is zero. Actually, that the number of ions is not equal to zero. Here the volume is infinity. What it implies that how the volume is infinity?
It is a special condition.
This is the special condition. Scientists Debye and Huckel, they gave a definition of infinite dilution. They say it is a condition in which an ion alone pending in a sea and interaction with other ions. I repeat, it is a special condition in which an ion alone pending in a sea of solvent and interacted with other ions. This is called the infinite dilution. In case of infinite dilution, there are no interionic interactions. In the next video, I will discuss the what is the interionic interactions actually. I will discuss their sum of effects. So I think this is sufficient for this video. You get a clear concept from the equivalent conductance. So.